Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zello Tech, and today Apple released iOS 13.2 Developer Beta 2. Now, it's out for developers, but it should be out for public beta testers either by the time you're watching this, or it could be a little bit later, or even the following day. It just depends on what Apple decides today. Now, this came in at 416.9 megabytes on my iPhone 6S Plus, and it was similarly sized on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. So it will be very similar to that, depending on which version you're on. If you're coming from a public version to the beta for the first time, expect it to be a much larger install. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number. The build number is 17B5068E, and that E signifies that we are a ways away from a final release, so I wouldn't expect a release for at least another month or so, but this one actually includes some fixes as well as some feature updates and changes. And the first thing they've changed is there's a new modem update. So if you were having connectivity issue, whether that be on an iPhone 6S Plus like I have here, or an iPhone 11 Pro Max, you may have better connectivity. We won't know for a few days if anything's changed as far as that goes, but hopefully if you were having issues, it resolves it for you. Now, Apple has not mentioned any issues in the notes. They haven't said there are any. There probably are a few, but they haven't mentioned any. And they've also resolved one issue that they've at least let us know about, and that has to do with NFC, or near field communication, on the iPhone 7 and 7 Plus. So there could have been an error with that. That's the NFC, or near field communication chipset, that's in here. When you tap on an RFID, you can do things like Apple Pay and other things. That should be resolved. Now, they've changed the way some of the user interface works with haptic or 3D touch. So if you haptic press an icon, you'll see it says delete Instagram. So we can delete that just by hitting delete now. We can also edit the home screen. That's replaced the rearrange apps icon. So now we can edit the home screen, all of your apps jiggle, and you can move them around. You can actually move them around still if you move it as soon as you feel a haptic touch or a haptic feedback. So you can move the icon. It's kind of like it rubber bands away from you. It's not great, but it is there, and they've changed that a little bit. Now, speaking of haptic pressing or 3D pressing, if I go into the music app and then I haptic press on, say, this album here, the share sheet is a little bit different. So you'll see we've got play and download, delete. If I bring in the previous version here, or 13.1.2, and do the same thing, it looks completely different. So they've changed it to more of the haptic press. I actually prefer the share sheet, but that's what they've changed so far. Now, the volume haptics feel a little bit different, and the animation has continued to change just a little bit. It stretches a little more, it seems, and you can feel it jiggle some more. As you go down, it's kind of shaking the phone, and the same is true on the home screen here. The volume is very prominent, much more so on the home screen. It just jiggles the phone a little bit more. Now, with this update comes new emoji. So to comply with Unicode 12, similar to what Android has done, iOS now has over 60 plus new emoji in it, and let me show you them. So you'll see here, we have everything from a pinching hand to a ringed planet, or Saturn, they call it a ringed planet. We now have some gender neutral things. We have some prostheses or prosthetics. We also have a skunk and a sloth, an ice cube, just a bunch of things that maybe we were missing before, as well as some different colors of circles and squares and a razor, a bunch of different things. They've also changed the way the emoji gender or skin selector works. So if we tap on this, and then maybe we want to pick the holding hands one here, you'll see it looks a little bit different. So we can just select whichever one works for us. So they've changed that around, looks a little bit different. And if you use emoji, you have over 60 new ones now, once this update is out to the public, or if you've got it on your device. Now, after I installed this update, I noticed a new message, and that message I wasn't able to screen capture it, but I took a photo of the iPad, and it gave me the option to improve Siri and dictation. And it says share audio recordings or not now. So if you want to pick not now, it won't share those audio recordings. And what Apple does is they got in trouble for this a little bit, but what Apple does is they actually send randomly your Siri recordings to verify. So maybe you spoke to Siri using dictation or something like that, and it was wrong and you had to go back and correct it. Apple actually listens to some of those to try and figure out what was wrong. Now, if you don't want that, obviously don't select it, but they've now given us an option to delete that information as well. So if we go into settings and then we go to Siri and search, we now have Siri and dictation history. So we can delete Siri and dictation history. And you'll see it says delete Siri and dictation interactions currently associated with this iPhone from Apple servers. Data that has been sampled to help improve Siri and dictation is no longer associated with this iPhone and will not be deleted. So you've got that option now. It's nice that they've put that in there. A lot of people gave them a hard time about that, rightfully so. And so that's gone now. Now, something they've added to only the iPhone 11, 11 Pro and 11 Pro Max, which I'm not sure why they didn't add it everywhere, but if you go into the camera and you go to video, you can now finally select your frame rate in the upper left. So if I tap on the word 4K, I can change it to 720p. Tap again, it goes HD, then it goes to 4K if I tap it again. If I tap on the actual frame rate, I can switch from 30 to 60 to 24 and back again. So finally that's been added back or added for the first time into the camera. And I'm really grateful to see it. Unfortunately, it's not on older devices. They could just as easily do that, but they've decided not to. And then there's one small change that I was able to find in the TV app. So let's go into that. And in the TV app, if you scroll down to say a new TV show, tap on the TV show, you've got a new add button here in the upper right. So if I add it, it says added. It looked completely different before. Now it's an actual word. So let me show you side by side. On the left is iOS 13.1.2. On the right is iOS 13.2 beta 2. And the word add is there instead of that little icon. I think the word add is much better. It's clearer as to what's going on and a needed change. And hopefully they do this throughout the OS. I think it's confusing for a lot of people. Even the little share button is confusing to some. Now, as far as other changes, I wasn't able to find anything major, but those are the major changes here. And there isn't much else. Now, as far as battery life is concerned, based off the previous beta, it needs some improvement. It's okay, but it's not great. And on the 11 Pro Max, when I was on a public version, it was much, much better. So you'll see 4 hours and 13 minutes, and I had about 20% battery life left. That's not great. In fact, I should be getting over 8 screen on time hours with this phone. And I'm just not seeing that with this beta. So hopefully beta 2 improves it. Beta 1, I urged many people not to install it. I had random bugs, all sorts of things. And so hopefully this fixes those, but it will take a few days to know how battery is overall. Now the overall speed, well, I've only been using it for a little over an hour. So the speed over an hour or so seems fine. Scrolling is smooth. And in fact, on older devices, it seems okay. So going through different menus, settings does not seem to be locking up. And RAM management, well, it'll take a few days to know that too, but closing and opening certain apps like the camera, they don't seem to reload every single time. So hopefully RAM management's a little bit better too. As far as changes with the iPad, there isn't really anything that I've found. It's all the same. You still get all those different emoji and things like that, but nothing really significant. If I haptic press, you've got all the same, or just press in this case, you've got delete iTunes and things like that. So there's all of the changes that come with iOS are also on iPadOS. Now, as far as Geekbench scores, I know a lot of you want to see that. So I ran a Geekbench on all of these devices. Let's take a closer look here. I used Geekbench 5 since that's the new standard, even though the numbers are lower. But with the iPhone 11 Pro Max, I scored 1,333 for single core, 3,491 for multi-core. If we take a look at the history, take a look at what we had last time. We had the exact same single core score. So 1,333, and we have a little bit higher by almost 200 or so multi-core score. So that's actually pretty good. I don't know that you're going to notice any significant differences, but it's there if you want to see it. Now, let me show you all of these devices. On the left, I have the iPad Air 2. In the middle, I have the iPhone 6S Plus. And on the right, I have the iPhone 11 Pro Max. And that should give you an idea. You're obviously going to see much better speeds and numbers and things like that on newer devices. But all of the older devices seem to perform pretty well with iOS 13. And hopefully it gets even better with iOS 13.2. That's it for iOS 13.2 Beta 2. Let me know what you think about it in the comments below. And if you found anything else I didn't mention, let me know if you'd like me to do a follow-up. I normally do later, maybe usually a few days later or so. And if you want me to, let me know in the comments below. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.